I think there is a spiritual aspect to living here. Everything that you do in Malibu is conducive to that feeling of spirituality. But it's not spirituality with a capital S for me. It's just, it is an encouragement daily to go and try something new. And for me, it was painting. The graphic opportunities that are here in Malibu pop into my vision constantly and effortlessly. Coming to Malibu, coming to California, coming to the United States from Europe, you get a fresh look at what someone who's born and bred here might just take for granted. I'm really aware of houses on the beach because we don't see them in Europe. I'm really aware of lifeguard towers because we don't have them in Britain. I'm really aware of the light. The light in winter is extraordinary. The shadows are inky black, hard-edged shadows. And in the summer, there's an intensity to the light, which is almost painful. And I think what it does, as I'm driving around, I'm very aware of these iconic California images. I really enjoy the graphics of street furniture, the telephone poles, the street lights. I went to art school in Kingston, which is a suburb of South London, and I did graphic design, worked in an advertising agency as an art director, and started directing TV commercials in 1970. It really was the halcyon days of TV commercials. There was a sort of British invasion where a lot of the commercials directors came here to make that transition from commercials to movies. Ridley Scott, obviously, Tony Scott, Alan Parker, Hugh Hudson. I didn't make the transition, but I didn't go back. I stayed here because I loved it. Drawing the storyboard, which was part of the process of directing a TV commercial, became the high point of making the commercial. And I thought, well, if that's what I'm enjoying most, then maybe I should try and do that more. And around the time, I was encouraged by my wife to paint. I did my first painting at age 50. I thought, I can do this. I really want to do this. I think Malibu is a liberating place. I'll get an idea when I'm driving around and I'll do a quick scribble of an image that I've seen and I'll approach that motif, that location, in the same way as I would approach a location for filming. I'll go back different times a day, do a light study with my camera. And I paint from photographs quite unashamedly because I'm really interested, having looked through a movie camera for 30 years, I'm very aware of the different spatial relationships that different lenses can give you. My most recent little scout for a location was up at Nicholas Canyon. And I'd been up there a couple of years ago. There's a lifeguard tower that overlooks the beach, and it's a good surf break, and I thought I'd make a terrific motif, very Malibu. And for some reason or other, I never got around to doing the painting, but I went back there a week or so ago, and it was thick fog, and we've had a very wet winter. There's the grass, it's very verdant, it's the foreground, and it's a foggy day. It's not the cliché blue sky and a hard light. I am looking at Malibu through the lens, but it's not a contrivance. So I've done my print, I've squared it up, I've squared up the canvas, and then I'll painstakingly draw it out in pencil. I use a very hard pencil, like a 3H, and then I fix it and do my monochrome underpainting of everything. And the more I find you do in that stage, the more enjoyable it becomes when you start to layer the colour. Relationship to Malibu is, it's my family, it's my home. So when I used to go away and film somewhere else in another part of the world, I'd come back here and I'd feel every time I came back more and more that Malibu was home. The gratitude I feel for being here is expressed by the paintings that I'm doing. And if somebody likes them, to me it's a shared enjoyment, but it's not an overt thank you. If I had to say the overt giving back thank you of my painting, it would be more of the Save the Children project. I'd get photographs of people from all over the world, from their childhood, to see if I can see any of the clues in their facial expressions, body language, whatever, that might lead to their later success or failure in later lives. I gave the paintings in the end to the participants, and they made a donation to Save the Children. It snowballed. I got to Cindy Crawford, she's a Malibu lady, and she gave me a great picture of herself as a little girl. What really impressed me about her was that she came here and she didn't spend more than 30 seconds looking at her own image. But she spent probably 30 minutes looking at everybody else's. She was more interested in her others than in herself. And as she left, she said, would you like George Clooney? And I did a painting of him. I loved this image with his hoodie on and these pants that are right up under his armpits. So I wrote to him and said, could you give me a quote? Because I'm going to do a book of this project. And he sent me back a line that said, I'll still wear those pants. Which I thought was wonderful. It's classic self-deprecating George Clooney. I am very grateful to getting up in the morning and thinking, what am I going to paint today? I spent most of my life being a commercial director because I didn't know what else to do. Thank you for my luck, for falling on my feet here and doing this. What Malibu allows us all to do is reinvent ourselves. I think we're allowed to be who we want to be. It brings out our ability to express ourselves in whatever way we choose. Thank you.